So, old school magic, this is where every week I like to sort of give a little throwback to those that have come before us, as far as like this age, this generation, whatever you want to call it, of magicians and such. 90% of the time they're dead guys. Sometimes they're still alive, but most of them are dead guys, and we're back to dead guys now. So, this is a dead guy magician, but again, totally one that, okay, yeah, thank you. I see you, Jeff Weeks, I see you, thank you. This is a guy that was super influential, and I gotta be honest, I was never really into him. Still not into him, but really respect what he does. There's a book called Spellbound. Highly recommend looking into that, because this week's Old School Magic is going to feature none other than the Canadian Hurricane himself, weighing in at a bunch of teeth and a mustache, Doug Henning, ladies and gentlemen. Doug Henning is this week's... Oh, God. Need to calm the down. Doug Henning, ladies and gentlemen, is this week's Old School Magic. So Doug Henning actually needs a big shout out, because he is, like I was saying, he's very much so responsible for modernizing magic. And you guys have probably seen at least pictures of him if you've never seen him do anything. This guy, honestly, like, even though, like I said, I was never really into it. You know, it's a little hippy dippy, a little too Burning Man for me. But that's all right. You know, that's all right. But he's responsible for modernizing magic. You know, up until Doug came along, it was kind of that, you know, that nightclub looking dude who was wearing, you know, like the blazer, the nightclub looking, you know, suit, or the even the full tuxedo, you know, was still like the thing back then. And Doug came along looking like this, you know, with his belt bottoms, his rainbow stuff. And is just like, just his whole demeanor, the way he presented magic was so genuine and really connected. And this is the stuff that I'm talking about that, like, I can see and I watch and I totally respect it. So I don't want to get misinterpreted or misunderstood, because that happens all the time on the internet now, because it's 2020 and everybody's a p-. So I just want to be clear that I'm saying totally respect Doug Henning, and he deserves it. I mean, this guy is responsible for helping people like Copperfield even come along. None of that would have happened, even where we are, you know, with David Blaine and Chris Angel and Cyril and Dynamo and all these guys. We wouldn't be where we are, or we wouldn't be where we are now. It might have still happened. It just would have happened a lot slower, I think. Doug really paved the way. I mean, he was doing Broadway, had TV specials, and his TV specials were live, okay? There was a TV, I think it was his first TV special. Any of you magicians that are watching, let me know, correct me in the chat, let me know. I think it was Doug's first TV special that was live. He was doing a bit with a tiger before it had gotten to the tiger bit, and the tiger, I shouldn't say bit and tiger in the same sentence. I saw a tiger, you cool cats and kittens. He was doing this tiger routine segment, it's called segment. He was doing this tiger segment where he had to, do something else. And backstage, the tiger got away and got out of his leash or his pen or something like that. And he started, you know, going around backstage. The tiger got loose, and it's a live TV show. And that's something else you don't see anymore. And hopefully, we will be able to come back to that real live TV magic. Nothing, not taking shots at anybody out there doing their thing right now, but there's a lot of fake magic on the internet and on apps like Netflix and other even shittier apps that I won't even bother to mention because nobody watches them. But it's Carol Baskin's fault. That's right. That's right, Maureen. But Doug was doing it live in studio. Like, you saw it on TV right along with everybody there in the audience. No stooges, nobody, nothing like that, man. It was the shite back in the day, you know, it was the shite back in the day. And unfortunately, we're not in those days anymore. Hopefully we'll get back to them, sooner than later. But this old school magic clip is Doug Henning doing probably one of the things that he is the most famous for. It's called Torn or Restored Newspaper. There's been many different versions. This is a version that is probably the most popular in the whole world. created by a guy in Michigan named Gene Anderson, who's a cool dude. I've hung out with Gene a couple times. Cool dude. And this is Doug doing it, and I think you'll get an idea of what I'm talking about as far as how Doug presents, you know, and how he performs and how he makes it so relatable and just he sucks you in. He sucks you in, right? So anyways, less talk and more rock. Here we go. We got Doug Henning for you, ladies and gentlemen. Obviously, again, we're back with another clip that looks like it was recorded on a potato. Okay, and the overalls, like, I mean, what a terrible, who created the overalls? Like, what a terrible thing to wear. I used to wear overalls and I hated it. You know why? Because even just to take a wee, like, it was chaos. It's pure chaos trying to use the restroom in overalls. It's just torture. That's right, Steve. Steve Haberman. Doug started with pure sleight of hand. He opened the show. Balls out. Opened the show by doing... If you see it, I thought about showing that clip, actually. But maybe I'll show it next week. But he started this show, this live TV special, right? And he basically made a quarter disappear, okay? So he made a quarter disappear. It doesn't look like much. It actually looks killer. I mean, it's so amazing. Quarter in his hand, closes his hand, opens it, quarter's gone, both sides of the hand, sleeves rolled up. Watch this. Boom, in your face, magic show. But even just making that quarter disappear is probably one of the most difficult, stressful sleight of hand magic tricks ever. You know, that Kyle always looked like the singer from the band Boston. You're not wrong. He does look like that, the singer from Boston, or like Freddie Mercury a little bit. You know, you can see a little Freddie Mercury here, can't you? A little, like a Freddie Mercury on a rainbow. Yeah. Okay. Moving on. Lots of material in there, but we're not going to do it. Anyways, because people kept asking you about the band Avatar. No. He opened the show, this live show that I was talking about. I mean, it was the coin, puts it on his hand, closes his fist like this, right? Opens it, the coin's gone, and, you know, nothing. Closes his hand, boom, coin comes back. It looks like that. Something that simple, the most, like I was saying, probably the most difficult, stressful, just, you know, you'd be diamonds, you know, like, so stressful to do that trick. And he was doing it live for a live audience and live for a camera audience at home, and, you know, it would have been all over right there, right out of the gate. That's how he opened the special, man. Legend, the legendary Doug Henning, rest in peace. So yes, that's Doug Henning. So that's that. What else are we going to talk about today?